Yo people, this is Cooch Dude, and today I'm going to show you 15 tips and tricks I learned from all the years of playing Minecraft. Now, you probably already watched several of these kinds of videos, but these are the tricks that I barely see anyone using. If you don't know anyone who used any of the tricks or tips I will tell you, let me know down in the comments so I can check them out. And without any delay, let us show you trick number one. Okay, there's some Endermen. I want to hunt some for Ender Pearls or other XP and stuff, but we know that fighting them like this is not a good idea. So, one thing that I do is I build what I call a mushroom. We go three blocks like this, then another side, three. Then we go like this, and like this. We can, whoa. Then we go like this, and then we can safely hunt these Endermen, and they won't be able to enter our little mushroom. So this is another simple tip, but one very good defense against mobs is having a wall, three blocks minimum, two blocks is probably fine. And then if you want, you can even add some stairs. Just one block away from each other, so mobs won't be able to climb them very well. But also, a two-block deep trench all around it, a few blocks away from the wall so creeper explosions won't damage it. Oh. And on the wall you can add glass on the outside edge. This is why you'd want it three blocks high to be able to do this. And then spiders won't be able to climb over, and mobs won't be able to hide under it. Right, another tip and a trick is, well, leather armor is the weakest armor, but cloth is weaker. But what the useful thing about them is that you can use them for camouflage. So, for example, if you get leather, color it with cactus green, then you would have full set of colored leather armor that's the same color as the forests, allowing you to blend in easily. So let me demonstrate. I actually tried this once in a multiplayer match, and I know it works, and it works really well. Okay, I'm exploring a cave. We're going deep. But what if we get lost? This is what signs are for. We just stick them, make them point an arrow saying, let's say, exit with arrows. And this, when we get lost, we can always just follow these signs and we'd reach the exit. This is a good way to make sure that you'll never get lost while exploring a cave. Okay, one other tip on fighting. Well, this isn't really a technique for fighting mobs, but it is really good with players, is that you always go around them and jump a lot, making it harder for them to hit you, but you're hitting them. Okay, another combat trick. Why do you need to bring a shovel and a pickaxe with blocks to you while fighting? It's really simple. Because when you're having blocks, you can place them, creating yourself cover against skeletons, and going on a little tower two blocks high allows you to hit zombies without them hitting you. another trick, but this one you probably all of you already heard about, is the debug. There's several things you can do with this. To be able to have a list of what can be done, just hold F3 and Q, and then you have options. These options can do a lot to help you while playing your survival Minecraft. Okay, I'm trying to sneak into someone's house, but sneaking is so slow and we're unable to fall down from blocks. Hold shift and quickly letting go of it, but crouching quickly after that. And this makes you be able to move quickly while sneaking and to fall down when you need to quickly. Oh boy. Bunch of zombies are coming after me, and all I have is a water bucket. No problem. Just pour it in and it'll slow them down, giving you enough time to run away. This can be also be used during combat against other players and mobs to make them fall wherever you want to, or to greatly slow them down and push them away. Oh, I'm mining, but I can't see behind me. This is simple. Just use the advantage of being able to do this to look behind you. Players usually will think you're looking forward, while you actually can see them behind. This will also help you see mobs trying to sneak up behind. Just remember to always switch back to actually see what's in front of you. Oh no, I'm falling. Just hold down right click with the water bucket. And that made me survive what could have been deadly. No, fishing rods aren't just only useful for fishing. It can also be used for multiple things. For example, there's a golden apple accidentally dropped there. You can actually use the fishing rod to grab it, and it'll be safe. There we go. And it can also be used to pull mobs toward us, letting us hit them, or use it as a leash. Oh no, this is hardcore, and I'm drowning, and I can't get up. But not to worry. Even though this deletes the world, I have a backup right over here where I can copy and paste it and play it all over again. Oh, I found some diamonds, but I don't have a single pickaxe. Maybe those creepers would kindly help me? And which they do! Indeed, you can use creepers to help you mine items. And also lure them into enemy bases, letting them do the dirty work for you. Lastly, the last tip and trick I have for you is to experiment on your own to figure out your own trips and tricks. So that's one of the best ways to learn tricks for Minecraft. So, if you have enjoyed this video or found it useful, don't forget to subscribe and to leave a like, and to follow me on Twitter and itch.io, and to comment down your own tips and tricks that you want to share, and I'll see you guys again in another video. Bye!